Hey y'all, what's up? It's Jessica. Welcome back. Thank you guys so much for tuning in today. It feels so good to be back here on YouTube. It's been so long since I've sat in this seat and chatted with you guys, and I miss being here. I've been keeping a little secret from you guys. I am pregnant. Oh my god, I can't believe it. That is why I have been gone, you guys. I have a human being inside of my belly doing the electric slide right now. So that is why I have been away for as long as I've been away. I mean, I'm not a stranger to breaks, let's be real. But that's why I had an extended break, because I was pregnant and I wasn't feeling my best. So I can't fake feeling good for the camera, period. It's just not in my, I can't do it. If I'm not feeling well, I won't be here. So I was ghost. But I'm gonna tell you guys all about it. I'm so excited. I feel like I'm talking to my friends, and like now I can spill the beans and tell you guys all about it. So let's dive into the video. All right, so yes, I'm pregnant. And first things first, I'm out of breath already, y'all. So if you hear me sound like I just ran a marathon, yes, already the out of breathness has started. If you followed my journey, if you follow me on Instagram and my channel, you guys know that I have suffered a miscarriage back in late August, early September. I had a miscarriage, and that was really, really hard to go through something like that. I shared my experience here because I felt like I was in a position, in a place, in a headspace to share it. I wasn't afraid to share it or afraid to talk about it. I felt like it was needed, and just like a different perspective on it. So I did share that, but I can't sit here and act like even after like I, you know, healed from it, that it didn't bother me, because we tried, you know, after. I've heard a bunch of scenarios of women saying that, you know, yeah, it's easy to conceive after you have a miscarriage. That's not the case for everybody's body. I did have some issues, you know, things. I was just like, what is going on with my body? So I'm gonna talk about that in another video, because I feel like that video will be beneficial. But yeah, so I tried to have a baby. I ended up having a chemical pregnancy after that. And then nothing happened after that. And then I was just kind of like, what the heck, like what's going on, like is there something wrong with my body? I kind of just got into the mindset to just like relax, like chill, like leave all the other stuff alone, and just like if it's meant to be, it'll be. I made my prayer really, really like intentional, and I prayed. I was like, God, I do want to have a baby, and I know it's in your another baby, and I know it's in your timing, but I would love to just get pregnant around Christmas time so that I can surprise my family. Like that will be like my surprise gift to my husband and my child. And I made that prayer and I prayed about it. And normally when I know I'm pregnant or about to become pregnant, before I have my period, you just feel really strange and weird. Like you feel things happening and you kind of know something is up. This time I didn't feel any of that. And even before, I would get like weird dreams. Like I would get a dream about a baby or something. It was kind of like telling me, hey, you know, something's happening in your body, like, you know, look out for a baby, look out for a positive pregnancy test or something like that. And I got no signs. Like I was like, whoa, okay, so there's no signs. I didn't get the dreams, I didn't get the weird feelings, like, oh, I feel strange, I feel weird. I didn't get any of that. I was just kind of just waiting for my period to like show up. I normally have my period comes like when I'm at home. Like I never really have it happen to me when I'm out in public. It literally comes like early in the morning before I'm even out or anything like that, and that didn't happen. So I was just waiting for her to like show up, like, okay girl, what's the tea, the time is ticking. So I didn't have any feminine products, and I told my husband to take me to Target. So he took me to Target, and I was about to buy myself some tampons, but something said, you know what, before you waste your money on tampons, why don't we buy just a couple of pregnancy tests? That way, if you are pregnant, you don't have to waste your money on tampons. And if you aren't pregnant, you just come back and get the tampons. It's no big deal. So I bought the pregnancy test and went home. It was raining actually, so like my husband kind of parked to where me and my daughter can get out. And then he went to go park the car in the garage so that, you know, he can do his man thing, you know, carry all the carry all the bags. He didn't know that I bought, no one knew I bought a pregnancy test. Everybody thought I bought tampons. So I hurried up, went in the house and shut the door because I have a nosy child and she knows what pregnancy tests are at this particular time. I mean, she's seen me take plenty. So I didn't want her to be like, Mom, you're pregnant? You're taking a pregnancy test? I didn't want no questions, okay? I just wanted to do this alone. So I went to the bathroom, took the test, and it came up. I buy the digital ones. Like, I don't want to see a line. I needed to say the words. And it said pregnant. And I was like, oh my God, heart just dropped because I didn't have any symptoms. So I was so excited and I was like, okay, I need to hurry up and put this stuff up before anybody catches me. I was trying to be sneaky. And it was perfect because it was December 22nd. So I had a few days before Christmas, but it was kind of like last minute kind of. And I was like, how am I gonna do this? Like, how am I gonna like surprise everybody? So what I ended up doing was taking like an old box, an old Fenty box or whatever, putting the pregnancy test in that and then wrapping it and then like addressing it to, I think, the Pettway family. And, or I don't know if I, yeah, I did. I put it from the Pettway family, but, or to the Pettway family. And I think like that was the last present under the tree. I handed it to my husband. He was like, oh, what's this? And I was like, oh, I think it's from my mom or something. While he was like opening the box, he looked and it was like a Fenty makeup box. And he was like, oh, this is for you. And I'm like, oh, well, just open it for me and just like see what's inside. And while he's opening it, I turned to my daughter and I said, Kai, what did you ask God for Christmas? And she was like, a baby. And I said, you want to open your gift? And she's like, yeah. So I lifted my shirt and I put a little bow. I had a bow on my stomach. And when I lifted my shirt, I had a little bow there. And I was like, well, he answered your prayers. This is your gift. You got a little baby in mommy's belly. And then my husband was like, wait, what? Are you serious? You're pregnant? And I'm like, yeah. So when he opened the box, he saw the pregnancy test. And he just got emo. Like, he just started. Because he was not expecting that, you guys. At all. He was like, no one expected it. So it was a really good surprise. And I was just so thankful to God that he answered my prayer and kind of gave me that, because it was a hard, hard 2019 was a hard year for us, like hecka hard. So that was just like ending the year off with that type of news and that blessing. It was just something that I'm just grateful to God for, because only he could do that. Like, throughout all the storms and things we went through, that moment, the last moment of the year, it just reminded us that no matter what storm you go through, that God always promises a rainbow at the end of every storm. And that was our rainbow at the end of 2019. So it was real special. Being pregnant with Kai, I remember just feeling not too much different, like noticing changes in my body, but the nausea, the sickness and all that stuff, I didn't have any of that. I was just like, I felt like my normal, but not normal self, but I wasn't sick. Like if a smell hit me the wrong way, I just wouldn't smell that anymore. Or if I would, foods that I would normally eat, and if it just tasted funny that time, I just wouldn't eat that anymore. But nothing too drastic to where I was like, whoa, slow down, what is this? But with this pregnancy, y'all, when I say this baby took me out, like this baby took me out of commission, motivation gone. Okay, I had no motivation, and not in like a depressive type of way. I just was not physically motivated to do anything. I wasn't mentally motivated to do anything. Like, I just needed to sit down. Physically, I just felt just sick, like all day just sick. And I'm like, ugh. And I'm not a throw upper. I don't throw up. So even if I feel sick, I would prefer to just deal with it than to throw up. It was a good thing that I just sat down and I just kind of like rested and gave my body a break to be able to just, you know, do its thing and really like take care of this baby and to just sit down and be pregnant. There's nothing wrong with that. I'm not gonna even front like the thought of a miscarriage didn't come to my mind, or just, I feel like the first trimester is just such a hard time. I don't remember it being as hard for me with Kai. I don't remember it, me being worried at all. I was just so happy. I was looking back at some like old photos and I was taking pictures of each week of my belly. Like, I wasn't worried about anything. But this time around, I guess after experiencing what I experienced, I was a little worried. Like, I'm like, I don't want to tell anybody right now. I don't want to tell family. I don't want to tell friends. I don't want to tell anyone. I want to just enjoy this pregnancy without everyone doing this. We didn't tell anyone until I was like 10 weeks after we had our first, my first ultrasound was at 10 weeks. And we got to actually see the baby. So, but let me tell you something. During the first 4 to 7 weeks, I was a mess in the sense of I was, like I said, I was worried. Like, the thought of miscarriage kept coming to my head. And then I'd be like, well, I went through it before, so I guess if it happens again, it just is what it is. And then I'd be like, no, but I don't want that to happen. Like, I want this baby. I prayed for this baby. I want this child. And I don't want to think that way. And I'm like, I want to see a doctor now. I think I was 5 weeks. So I'm like, because of what I went through, I need to see that there's something in there. Like, I don't want to just see an empty sack. I need to know that there's something there so I can just like kind of be calm, because right now I'm not calm. Right now I'm just panicky. And that's just too long. I got to wait 5 more weeks just to find out if something is in there. And so it was a lot on me mentally. So I prayed and I asked God if there was some way that he would just allow me to hear my baby's heartbeat. And I know it was pretty early. It was like, I was only 7 weeks, but I was like, I just want to hear my baby's heartbeat. That will give me some peace of mind. That will ease me just to know somebody is in there. Because when I went to my last ultrasound, I didn't see any, my last ultrasound with my last pregnancy, I didn't see anything inside. Okay, it was just an empty sack. And I remember before I even saw the ultrasound, I would put my Doppler to my stomach and I remember just not finding anything. And seeing it confirmed on the ultrasound that there was nothing there, that was kind of devastating and it hurt a lot. It was like 7 weeks and 4 days and I put the Doppler to my stomach and I just remember hearing my baby's heartbeat and literally feeling the biggest relief hearing that heartbeat just beep, 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 beep. And I'm like, oh my God, there's somebody in here. And I found it at 7 weeks and I'm like, and I was just really grateful because I feel like God has just been with me during this entire process and just reminding me that I got you, I'm hearing you, and don't worry. Basically, I got you, I hear you, don't worry. So I heard my baby and that gave me a lot of peace of mind, because now I can wait until the 10 weeks and be like, well, I've heard the heartbeat, I recorded the heartbeat, so I can hear it on demand whenever I want. And it was just like the confirmation that somebody is there. I needed that confirmation. A few weeks after that, around 9 weeks, I started feeling my baby move. And I'm like, already? I can feel this baby just like little jelly bean just jumping in there and going nuts. So there was a lot of firsts with this baby that I didn't have with Kai. When I went to my appointment, I was very calm. I wasn't worried like, what are they gonna find on the ultrasound? Because I've heard the baby's heartbeat, got to see my little wiggle worm. This baby moves so much. The doctor was like, you have a very active baby. Like, this for a 10-week-old, this baby is moving a lot. So that was maybe like 5 weeks ago, because I am now 15 weeks pregnant and my baby is measuring a week ahead. So yeah, the baby is measuring like 16 weeks and I technically 15 weeks. So I just had my doctor's appointment a few days ago and she's like, yeah, your baby is pretty long, pretty tall, so you probably are gonna have a really tall baby. Everything looks healthy with the baby. I could feel the baby move. I can feel the baby just doing its thing and I'm just loving on it even more every day that it's becoming more real, because it really didn't hit me until I saw it on the ultrasound when I was 10 weeks. And I'm like, oh, there's like, I heard the heartbeat, so I know someone's in there, but like seeing the arms and the head and the legs move and jump, and I'm like, that's what I've been feeling. It just was like, bam, it really hit me. So it's like, hold on. Starting to settle in that Jessica is definitely pregnant. I'm feeling better now, so I wanna like, you know, start to enjoy feeling better, because there's nothing like that first trimester, let me tell you. But now I'm gonna share with you guys my belly so you can see my tummy, and I'm gonna be doing updates. Not weekly updates, I don't feel like that's necessary, but I'll probably do like a once a month pregnancy update video. So 15 week belly shot, let me go ahead and stand up. Here is my belly. Can y'all see it? that is my belly from the side. So I have PJ bottoms on, don't judge me, but yeah, this is the belly. All right, y'all, that is all. I just wanted to share that with you guys. I'm so excited. Let me know down below what you guys think I'm having, like boy or girl. I already have an idea of what I think I'm having. I don't know for sure yet. They couldn't tell on the ultrasound. I was trying to find out. Let me know what other type of pregnancy videos you guys want. Definitely gonna be serving some maternity fashion. And then whatever type of videos you guys want to see from me, just let me know. I'm excited to be back. I'm excited for my little beau baby. That's my baby's name. Be sure to subscribe to my channel if you are not subscribed, and hit the bell so you're notified. I know that they be tripping with the notifications. It's all good. Just check out my channel to see if I posted something. And give this video a like if you liked it. Share with a friend. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.